My name's Ben Gaffner, and my job title is the Visual Engineering Lead for Jacobs. So we work with virtual reality and augmented reality. We would use VR when we're in the design development stages. So when we want our engineers to view the virtual reality world and view their models in a real one-to-one environment. Traditionally, we have 2D flat drawings and then 3D models. 3D models are great because you can spin them around and you can get an idea of how models interact with each other. But having a virtual world that you can jump into allows the engineers to get much, much closer to the environment that they'll be working in. And also on top of that, we use virtual reality for importing in point cloud data. So we work on a lot of sites that are in difficult to reach places. There's a lot of travel involved. So it allows our engineers who maybe wouldn't have had opportunity to go to site to be able to walk around the facility that they'll be designing equipment to go in, or they'll be decommissioning in a safe, controlled environment, and they can go through it as many times as they want to. Augmented reality, we tend to use that when we're dealing with actual sites themselves. So if we're dealing with operators and they're having to walk around, do site walk downs, inspect equipment. For instance, if an operator was walking around site and they had a question about a specific piece of equipment that they didn't know a lot of information about, say they were just walking past it and it wasn't part of their remit, they could have a quick Teams call with the headset completely hands-free and show the person on the other end, the subject matter expert, exactly what they thought the issue might be, or ask more questions about it. And then on the other side of it, the more development side of it, is we can implement 3D models into the virtual space. So like virtual reality, we can bring in models and build up the world around us. In augmented reality, we can do the exact same thing. The difference being is that they will be pinned to real world environments. A lot of people are blown away by how ready the technology is when they actually see their projects in virtual space and understand how quick it is to get them into that environment. They're really blown away with the fact that it is ready. It's something that we can use now, today.
There are four main benefits I see to clients using this technology. Firstly, risk reduction in terms of safety at our client site, accelerating their programmes of delivery, also being able to reduce costs where possible, and sustainability benefits. From a schedule perspective, being able to visualise your project stages much earlier in the life cycle can potentially contract the programme because you're making decisions much earlier. Again, costs can be saved through bringing stakeholders together through a more collaborative approach. They can make decisions earlier.
I very much want to work with our clients and say, look, we will bring expertise because we're seeing it across multiple clients. So you may have some very specific needs, but we can bring something to you that we've used in several areas. So we're bringing a broader experience that you wouldn't necessarily see yourself. So the way to look at that is really the limit is your imagination.
And it's definitely not just a tool for nuclear, absolutely not. It's a tool for every industry. And I think it's just the way engineering will go. I think it's the way the world will go in the next few years. Sometimes VR is seen as a nice to have and a bit of a marketing tool. But what we're really trying to show is that it is an engineering tool, and we're using it on live projects, and we've seen tangible benefits from using it. And I think if anybody's on the fence, all I would say is just get in touch. What we're really trying to do is make sure that everybody's aware that the hardware and the software is available, accessible, and it's a tool that we can use on any project.